JEA's incident command team has been monitoring Dorian for almost a week now. Let me take you inside JEA's EOC, and I'll show you what I mean.
This is JEA's EOC, where every table here represents something that we're monitoring. Here with me today is Daryl Calhoun, who's the VP of our water wastewater system. Daryl, how are things looking?
Things are looking great so far, Greg. This is a great tool that we've developed that allows us to look at our over 1,500 wastewater pump stations here at the EOC. And what you see are the wet well levels at each wastewater pump station. You see that we have generators running proactively at various pump stations. We also are monitoring our potable water pressures there in the blue. And there's a power outage right there. It allows us to see a lot of information on one screen.
And so what does this mean to our customers?
Well, for our customers, it keeps wastewater off the street. That's our ultimate goal here. We want to know how full a lift station might be. Is it out of power? Where should we deploy our crews next?
Okay. Thank you very much, Daryl.
Thank you.
We're over here with Ricky Erickson to talk a little bit about outages. Ricky is the Senior Director of Electric Transmission and Maintenance. Ricky, what do we got going on here?
Well, here's our outage map. This is the outage map that any customer can see on the web. So we can show all of our customers what's going on with our outages. But this is what we really use. This is our really detailed outage information. We show each individual circuit that we have out in the field. We show how many customers are assigned and how many customers are currently out, how many tickets are associated with each one. This is how we help manage priorities and restore power. Here we have also which crews we have labeled for each circuit, which outage they're working on, where they are in that particular outage. So this is really very useful in our coordinators, our dispatchers, and our management to manage the storm.
Okay, so if I'm at home and I go onto JEA.com on either my computer or on my phone, this is the information that I'm looking at. It's the same information.
This information drives this.
Oh, okay.
So yes, it does. That's
really helpful. So our customers know exactly what you're looking at is the same thing that they're looking
that's
at.
That's right.
That's great. Thank you very much, Ricky.
Sure.
We're here with Keith Joyner. He's our GIS analyst here at JEA. And he's going to show you a little bit about how we use GIS information to drive what we do it here at JEA as far as restoration. So, Keith, can you show us a little bit about what you're doing here?
Sure. Well, GIS is a geographic information system. It's computerized mapping. And in this case, we have a map depicting what we call critical infrastructure or critical facilities that consist of hospitals, fire stations, police stations. And this map tells us whether these facilities are energized or whether they're dark and which ones we need to prioritize for restoration purposes. This map over here shows us incoming damage assessments real time from the field as our assessors are out there assessing damage after the storm. And it tells us things like how many poles we currently have down, how many lines we have down, how many trees are down over wires and things like that. And that helps us to prioritize the areas that we need to begin restoration and help expedite the restoration process and get you back into energy as fast as possible.
Okay, so we will utilize this information as part of the restoration 1-2-3 process. Certainly in the restoration 1 phase, we can have a geographic representation of what we need to do and where we need to send our assets. Is that right?
Sure is. Situational awareness is very important to an operations center like this and to ensure that we're energizing our customers as quickly as possible.
Great information, Keith. Thanks.
Thank you.
We hope this has given you an idea of how JEA's EOC works and how we are monitoring the storm to protect our community. Stay safe, Jacksonville.